Here, the system, in the system of gas, the cyclic process taken place according to the graph as shown here in PV graph. The system changes takes place from A to B, B to C, and C to A. Okay, here the gas taken is having one mole. One mole gas is taken. At state A, the thermodynamic coordinates of the system or gas are pressure P naught and volume V naught. Of course, when we are given P naught and V naught, we know the temperature at this point by using the ideal gas equation. Because any gas obeys the gas equation. That's why by using that one, we can find the temperature at this point. Similarly, here pressure is known, volume is known. So temperature can be formed. Here also temperature can be formed. Okay, then here the question is, first one, work done by the gas is what? Work done by the gas is what? So in first case, what is the work done by the total work done in the cyclic process? They asked work done by the gas. W is equal to question mark. Not only along AB process or BC path or CA path, they asked work done means total work done in the cyclic process. What is the total work done in the cyclic process? What is the total work done in the cyclic process? Tell me. It is the PV graph. It is the PV graph. No. It is the PV graph, no? So in case of PV graph, the work done in the cyclic process, the area bounded by closed path, no? Area bounded by closed curve. If it is PT graph, we should not use that area to find the work done. Only in case of PV graph only, because already we proved work done is equal to integral P into dV. Work done is equal to integral P dV. Okay, that means when pressure volume graph is given, then only the area bounded by the closed curve in the cyclic process gives the net work done in that cyclic process. Net work done in the cyclic process. Okay, very good now. Straight up. Okay, therefore work done is equal to area bounded. Area bounded by cyclic, this closed curve. Area bounded by closed curve. So what is the area bounded? It is the cyclic process represented with the graph in the form of a triangle. Closed path is represented in the form of a triangle. That's why half base, base means AC, into height means AB. So you substitute the data. So work done is equal to half. AC means, what is AC? This line is parallel to volume axis. That's why 2V0 minus V0 is the length of this AC graph. No? That's why 2V0 minus V0 into height. Height means this one. This line is parallel to pressure axis. That's why the reading here and this reading here, the difference between these two readings gives length of this side. That's why 3P0 minus V0. 3P0 minus V0. Okay. This is equal to V0 here, 2P0 by 2. 2 to cancel. So P0, V0. V0, V0 is the network done in this process. P0, V0. V0, V0, no? Karthik ready? Karthik ready. The area bounded is P0, V0, no? You see? Karthik ready. Area bounded is equal to P0, V0, V0. We will get, no? So this is the, okay. This is the amount of work done in this cyclic process. Suppose what is the work done? What is the work done in the process from C to A? If they ask, not total work done. Here they ask, not net work done. Just from the path from C to A, what is the work done if they ask? Then what is that work done? Anybody else respond in the chat box? C to A, what is the work done? Prantesh? From C to A, what is the work done? You respond. From C to A, yeah, P naught, V naught. P naught, V naught is the work done. Because in C to A process, work done means it is not the cyclic process. Only PV graph is given as a straight line. So what is the work done means? The graph, PV graph, the area under PV graph and volume axis means this is the area. This is the work done from the process from C to A. So area under this one means this is just like a rectangle. So length into breadth. Length is equal to 2V0, this graph length is equal to 2V0 minus V0, that is equal to V0 into P0. Is it positive work or negative work? Is it positive work or negative work? Madhuri Mehta. Is it positive work or negative work? Percentage. Yeah, negative one. Because whenever the graph is from C to A, the volume decreases. When volume decreases, means gas compresses. When gas compresses, work done is negative. No? Actually, work done is equal to integral 3 dV. dV is negative. That's why work done, you will get negative. That's why when the gas is compressed, negative work is done. Negative work is done. Okay. Terence, voice breaking. Remaining people, please respond. Is my voice is clearly hearing by you or not? Are you hearing clearly? Okay. Most of the students says that voice is okay. It's not breaking. I think there is a network problem, you see. Okay. Right. So this is the work done. What is the work done in the process from A to B? What is the work done in the process from A to B in the graph? Tell me. You see here, from A to B graph is there. What is the work done in this process from A to B? Very good, Siddhu. What is the type of process? Okay, Deepak, how did you get 2P0, P0 in the process from A to B? 1 minute. Deepak, 1 minute. I will unmute you, speak with me.
So 3P0 V0 minus
1 minute, Deepak, 1 minute. I am unable to hear your words. Hello,
sir.
Deepak, Tipna. How did you get 2P0 V0? In the process from A to B, what is the area bounded?
Sir, I did 3P0 V0 minus P0 V0, sir.
Actually, graph is from A to B means this is the graph, no?
Yes, sir.
What is the area bounded by this graph? Area under this graph and the volume axis. Here it is a straight line. Volume remains constant, no? From A to B, there is no change in the volume. Actually, work done means pressure into change in volume. Is there a change in volume here?
No, sir.
When there is no change in volume, how work is done? Okay, zero work is done.
Okay.
Okay, Deepak. Okay. Right now.
Thank you.
Okay. Zero work is done. Okay. Of course. From B to C, how we can find the work done means area under the graph. From B to C means this is a straight line. Here. The area under the straight area between the straight line and volume axis gives work done. So that means this is the area bounded. Okay, this is just like a trapezium. So area of the trapezium gives the work done in this process from B to C. Or the area in this graph, from this graph to volume axis, if there is a triangle and there is a rectangle, the areas of these two gives the total area under this graph. That gives the work done from B to C process. Is the work done is positive or negative? From B to C process, is work done is positive or negative? Is the work done positive or negative? Positive. Very good. Because from B to C, when you move from B to C, as the volume increases, so work done is positive. Okay, this is one question. Next, heat rejected in the process from C to A. In this B, heat rejected in the process from B to C to A, the aspect. Heat rejected in the process from C to A, they asked. Heat rejected in the process from C to A. How we can do? Heat rejected in the process from C to A means how we can find? Because from C to A process, what about the pressure? From C to A process, what is the pressure? So heat rejected. They asked the heat rejected. From C to A process, they asked the heat rejected. Because volume decreases, no? Here volume decreases, pressure is constant. Here pressure is constant. When at a constant pressure, when volume decreases, then actually gas is compressed. At a constant pressure, when volume decreases, then temperature also decreases. Because at constant pressure, volume is directly proportional to temperature, no? So this is the isobaric process. From C to A, isobaric process. From A to C, what is the process? Which type of process takes place from A to C? A to B. From A to B, what is the type of process takes place? Isochoric process are very good. Very good, now good pick. Isochoric process or isovolumic process. From B to C. Here, from B to C, neither pressure, volume, nor temperature remains constant. That's why it is one polytropic process. Okay? Right. So here, heat rejected in the process from C to A means from C to A. At constant pressure, as the volume decreases, temperature decreases. When temperature decreases, definitely some heat energy is lost. That heat energy lost by the system is called as the heat energy rejected by the system. So it is the isobaric process. In isobaric process, what is the heat energy rejected? Of course, by using first law thermodynamics, we can find the dq, which is the heat energy rejected, or directly by molar specified at constant pressure also we can find. Because at constant pressure, as the volume decreases, then what is the fall of temperature? If you know, then by using that equation, at constant pressure, heat energy required to rise the temperature or to decrease the temperature is equal to Q is equal to, suppose temperature rises, then heat energy required or heat energy given to the system, that is equal to NCP dT. Or if the temperature falls, it is the heat energy rejected by the system to the sink or surroundings. By using Sriram, by using first law of thermodynamics also we can calculate. Because from first law of thermodynamics, dq is equal to du plus dw. From C to A process, what is the work done you have to calculate? From C to A process, what is the change in internal energy we have to calculate? Okay, then when you substitute in that first law of thermodynamics, then we can have the heat energy rejected. But here directly, by using this formula, we can find directly. When you know the temperatures. Temperature at point C and temperature at point A. Here you see, Q is equal to N into Cp means, how we can write Cp? Gamma R by gamma minus 1, no? Molar specific constant pressure is gamma R by gamma minus 1 into dT. dT means final temperature minus initial temperature. If state changes takes place from C to A, that's why at this point, whatever the temperature, that is the final temperature, here this temperature is the initial temperature. So, TA minus TC. So, we know everyone, because the type of the gas given is monoatomic. For monoatomic, already we know this gamma value. For monoatomic, what is the gamma value? Tell me. For monoatomic gas, what is the gamma value? You better to write in terms of fraction. Okay, for monoatomic gas means 5 by 3, no? You write better to write like this. You don't write like 1.66 like that. You better to remember like this only, because calculation becomes easy. Okay? Okay, pick. Right, 5 by 3. Better to remember like this. Pick. Right. So, we know N value, we know gamma value, we know capital R value. What about TA and TC? We have to calculate. At A, from ideal gas equation, PV is equal to NRP. Because in any process, the gases obey the ideal gas equation. Okay, P means at this point, pressure is V0, volume is V0. Next, N means 1. In terms of universal gas constant only, first you write. Because answer, I think it is given in universal gas constant only, in terms of. Capital T means TA. So that implies TA is equal to V0 by R. This is equation 1. Okay. Next, at B, we find all the temperatures, because these are useful to do other concept, concept also, other problem also. Okay. So at C, what is the pressure? At C, temperature TC is equal to, general formula is like this only. PV by P. P means pressure at C, V means volume at C, by R into, because N is equal to 1. General formula is NR, PV, T PC is equal to PC VC by NR. That is equal to PC means pressure at C. Pressure at C is P naught only. Volume at C is P naught by N is 1 into R. Okay, that is equal to 2 P naught V naught by R. So this is the temperature at C. So we know the temperature at C. Therefore, this is equation. Say it is a 1, it is 2, it is 3. So 2 and 3, from 2 and 3, you substitute the temperature values in 1, then we will get Q is equal to N means 1, gamma means pi by 3, R by gamma minus 1, pi by 3 minus 1 into TA minus TC. TA is equal to P naught V naught by R, P naught V naught by R minus TC, 2 P naught V naught by R. 2 P naught V naught by R. So this is equal to 5 by 3 R. 5 by 3 minus 1 means 2 by 3. We can write. Okay. Here, when you simplify them here, minus P naught V naught by R you will get now. So here R, R cancel. 3, 3 cancel. So minus 5 P naught V naught by minus 5 P naught V naught by 2 we got. Okay. Here, minus sign represents, it is the heat energy rejected. Here, minus sign represents heat energy rejected or heat energy lost by the system to fall the temperature. And if whenever the state changes takes place from C to E, C to A, as the temperature decreases, because TA less than TC, you know, as the temperature decreases, this amount of heat energy is lost. Minus sign represents heat energy lost by the system. That is also called as the heat energy rejected by the system to the surroundings. Okay. Plus option kondi, if you get positive value, then heat energy is absorbed by the system or heat energy taken by the system from the surroundings. As we got negative sign here, it represents heat energy rejected or lost by the system. All okay. So this is the heat energy lost or rejected by the system to the surroundings when state changes takes place from C to A. Okay, note down. Next, one more question in this. See, heat absorbed in the process from A to B. Heat absorbed in the process from A to B. Heat absorbed in the process from A to B. That is a QAB. Heat absorbed in the process from A to B means, from A to B, what is the type of process takes place in the gas? From A to B, what is the type of process takes place in the, yeah, very good, Nana. Very good to speak. Isophoric process. Okay. From A to B process is the isophoric or isovolumic. Isophoric process. In isophoric process, heat energy absorbed or rejected, Q is equal to NCV dT, no? NCV dT. That is equal to N into CV means R by gamma minus 1 into dT. Final temperature minus initial temperature. As the process takes place from A to B, the final temperature is TB, initial temperature is TA. That's why TB minus TA you have to write. TB minus TA. Of course, we know the temperature at A and C. We know the temperature at A, but temperature at B is not known. So far, we did not calculate. Thus, we had to calculate the temperature at this point. So, at B, PAVA, at B, no, PBVB is equal to NR into TB. So, from that, what about TB value? PB is equal to, you see, PB, VB by NR. PB means at B, pressure is VP naught, volume is V naught, number of moles 1 into capital R. That is equal to 3 P naught V naught by capital R. It is the temperature at P. Okay. Therefore, from the formula, Q is equal to heat energy. From A to B process, what is the heat is absorbed or rejected. So PAB is equal to. Of course, here as it is isochoric process or isovolumic process, whenever from the process state changes takes place from A to B at constant volume, the pressure is directly proportional to temperature. As pressure increases from A to B, the temperature also increases. That's why temperature at B is greater than temperature at A. Of course, we got same. Temperature at B is greater than that of temperature at A. Temperature at A we got here now, P naught, P naught by R. Okay, now we substitute here. From that formula, L means 1, N is 1 into R by gamma minus 1 means 5 by 3 minus 1 because it is a monatomic gas. TV minus TA. TV is equal to 3 P naught V naught by Kepler minus TA. Already we got here. P naught V naught by Kepler. Therefore, QAB is equal to R. Simplification, what you will get? That is equal to 3R by 2 here. R by 5 by 3 minus 1 means 2 by 3. That means 3R by 2 into, after subtraction here, you will get 2 V naught V naught by R. No? 2 cancel, RR cancel. So 3 P naught V naught. So we got positive sign means definitely as the temperature increases, heat energy is absorbed by the system or gas. Heat energy absorbed by the system or gas. Okay. Note of 3 P naught V naught is the answer. Yes. Next, from B to C, what about the heat energy? Is it absorbed or rejected? Is it absorbed or rejected? From B to C process. We have calculated, okay? Shall I erase this part? Shall I erase this part? Next D, heat absorbed in the process from B to C. Heat absorbed in the process from B to C. Heat absorbed in the process from B to C. Okay, you see, at the point B temperature is known, at the point C temperature is known. Area under the graph is known means work done is known. Okay, then in this process, what is the heat energy absorbed means by using, because it is not the isobaric process or isochoric process to find the heat energy directly. That's why in this process, work done is known. From B to C process, work done is known. In B to C process, work done is known. As the temperatures are given, we know the change in internal energy also. Okay, when you know the change in internal energy and work done, then by using the first law of thermodynamics, we can calculate the heat energy absorbed or rejected. Okay. From first law of thermodynamics, heat energy absorbed or rejected, that is equal to QBC. That is equal to change in internal energy in this process from B to C plus amount of work done in the process from B to C. Okay. Change in internal energy means temperatures must be known. Final temperature, initial temperature, these are known. That's why change in internal energy, DUBC, is equal to, what is the formula for change in internal energy? When you know the temperatures, yes, NCV dT. Very good now. NCV dT. That is equal to N into CV means R by gamma minus 1 into dT means final temperature minus initial temperature. In the process from B to C, because the arrow mark is towards C, that's why in the process from B to C, the final temperature is TC and initial temperature is CV. That's why TC minus CV. This is equal to N means N is equal to 1. Into inertial gas constant by gamma minus 1 means 5 by 3 minus 1 into TC minus TB. TC we got somewhere now. What is the TC value we got? TC. Okay. 3 P naught V naught by R, I think we got. 2 P naught V naught by R now. TC means TC here now. 2 2 P naught V naught by R minus TV. TV means we got 3 P naught V naught by R. No, TV is equal to we got 3 P naught V naught by R. 3 P naught V naught by R we got. Okay. Now substitute here. V R by 2 into minus P naught V naught by R we have. R R cancelled. Therefore, du bc. That means from the process from B to C, the change in internal energy is equal to minus 3 P naught V naught by 2. Minus 3 P naught V naught by 2. That means heat energy is here. The internal energy decreases. That means temperature falls. Of course, from this also we know TC value is there, TP value here, TC value is here. So by this also, as the temperature falls, no doubt internal energy decreases. That's why you got negative sign. Okay, next, what about the work done from B to C process? Work done from B to C process is equal to, of course, we can write QBC is equal to delta U plus delta W. We can write DWBC is equal to, what is DWBC? Area under the graph, because it is a PV graph. B to C, we are given PV graph. Area under PV graph gives work done only. So that's why area under the graph we had to calculate. Area under B to C graph. Area under B, here is the work done from B to C, positive or negative? Work done from B to C, positive or negative work done? Work done from B to C is positive work or negative work? Because the volume increases, no? When you move from B to C, as the volume increases, definitely work done is positive. What is that positive work done? Area under the graph. Area under the graph means it is just like a trapezium. Area of the trapezium means half into sum of the length of parallel sides. Here this is these two are parallel sides. Sum of length of two parallel sides means it is equal to 3 P naught. It is equal to P naught. 3 P naught plus P naught. 3 P naught plus P naught into perpendicular distance between two parallel sides means these are the two parallel sides in the trapezium. Perpendicular distance between these two is this one. That is equal to this one. Okay, that is equal to 2 V naught minus P naught. 2 V naught minus P naught is this distance. That is equal to here 4 P naught by 2. That means 2 P naught V naught, 2 P naught into V naught. So 2 P naught V naught. So here we got work done is positive. Therefore, from this expression, from this equation, QBC is equal to DUBC plus DWBC. What is DUBC? Already we got minus 3 P naught V naught by 2. DWBC means positive. 2 P naught V naught. That is equal to, when you simplify them, P naught V naught by 2 we got. P naught V naught by 2 we got. Okay, already somebody has mentioned P naught V naught by 2. Okay, so that is the work in the process from B to C. Next important one is maximum temperature. From the graph, no doubt, from this graph, TA, TB, TC are more. TA, TB, TC are more. Okay, here TA, TB, TC values are obtained. From that, we can say temperature here is more, temperature here is less. Temperature here is more compared with temperature at C. That means the minimum temperature is here, I think, at C only, no? Because at C, we got temperature is equal to, 2 P naught V naught by R. Temperature at C, we got 2 P naught V naught by R. Temperature at A is equal to P naught V naught by R only. That means temperature at A is minimum. Temperature at A is minimum. Temperature at C is moderate. That is equal to 2 P naught V naught by R. Temperature at B is maximum in this. Not maximum. In this, at these corners of the triangle, temperature is maximum at C. When you move here, definitely, when you move from B to C, is the temperature is more or less? Is any maximum value is the maximum value is here only or any in between these two points, anywhere else temperature is maximum? We have to find. Okay, because it is not linear relation. Here in between the temperature and volume or temperature and pressure, it is not the linear relation. It is a polytropic process. Definitely, where the temperature is more, first we have to find. Is the temperature is more on this graph or on this graph or on this graph? First we have to identify. Okay. So in this, have you noted this one? Have you noted this one? Okay, area of the trapezium, I will explain. Okay. You see, here, this is the area under this graph BC we had to find. Area under BC graph we had to find. From this end of the graph, you draw a vertical line. From this end of the graph, you draw a vertical line. Okay, now, in this closed path, four sides are there. That's why it is a trapezium. In this trapezium, this side and this side, both are parallel. No? That's why it is called trapezium. These two sides are parallel. That's why it is called trapezium. Prithvik. Okay, now, what is the formula for area of the trapezium? I said already. Area of the trapezium means half into sum of the length of two parallel sides. And the length to length. This length and this length. Both are parallel sides. The sum of these two lengths means this length is equal to 3p naught. Because this length is parallel to pressure axis. Kabati, e end degree 0, e end degree 3p naught. Kabati, length of this side is equal to 3p naught. Length of this side is equal to p naught. Because it is origin. Okay, now sum of the lengths of two parallel sides means 3p naught plus p naught. 3p naught plus p naught. 3p naught plus p naught. Okay, into perpendicular distance between two parallel sides. And e side ki majha perpendicular distance and e length and e 2v naught minus p naught. That is equal to v naught. Okay. Okay, Shukrik. Right. Okay. Now, shall I erase now this part? Shall I erase this part? Highest temperature is 2P by something. No, I think. No, that is not correct. Highest temperature is not 2P naught or something. 4P naught, V naught by R. That is not correct. Okay, I will discuss. Now, where the temperature is more, first we have to calculate that one. Where the temperature is more. Next, maximum temperature in the process. Maximum temperature attained by the gas in the process. Maximum temperature attained by gas in the process. Tmax. Maximum temperature attained by the gas in the cyclic process. In this entire process, what is the maximum temperature? Where the maximum temperature acquired and at what is that value? So at any point here, at any point in the graph here or here, anywhere, pressure is say P, volume is say V, temperature is say T. Then from PV is equal to nRT. As n is equal to 1, we can write RT. Therefore, from this, here R is constant. That's why PV is proportional to temperature, no? PV is proportional to temperature. PV means area under the graph. Area under the graph is proportional to temperature. Where area under the graph is more, temperature is more in that case. Here, from the graph, under which graph the pressure, the area is more? Under which graph area is more? Is it BC graph or CA graph or AB graph? Under which graph area is more? Area is more under BC graph. Very good. Area, Karthik Reddy. Area under BC graph is more. That's why as area under BC graph is more, temperature is also more there only. That means here on this graph only temperature is maximum. Temperature is more. So where the temperature is maximum? We have to find. Is it maximum temperature or any other other place temperature is maximum? We have to find that one. That is our aim. So this PV is area under PV graph. Area under PV graph. That is directly proportional to T. Therefore, temperature is maximum on the graph. From, because it is not the isochoric process or isobaric process. Suppose if it is, here you see, as the volume is constant here, definitely on this graph where the temperature is maximum at B, we can say directly, because on this graph volume is constant. When volume is constant, pressure is directly proportional to temperature. So on this graph where the pressure is maximum, temperature is maximum there only, because P is proportional to T, because the volume is constant. On this graph where the temperature is maximum means here on this graph pressure is constant. At constant pressure, volume is directly proportional to temperature. Where the volume is more, temperature is more. That's why compared with this one, at C, temperature is maximum. We can say like that. But this graph is neither isobaric, neither isobaric nor isocoric. So we cannot say directly. That's why in BC process, in the process from B to C, where the temperature is maximum? Is it maximum this only or this only? Is it this temperature only maximum or anywhere else in between these two? Temperature is maximum. That to identify. Okay, that's why temperature is maximum. First of all, on which graph, on which line the temperature is maximum, first we identify. So according to this explanation here, no doubt temperature is maximum on BC line, because it is not isochoric or isobaric to say directly where the temperature is maximum. Okay, that's why. But temperature is no doubt maximum on this line. So what is that maximum temperature we had to find? So temperature is maximum on the graph from B to C. Is it maximum to B or is it maximum at any point somewhere else in between B and C? We have to enter. For that, first we have to write the equation for this graph. Suppose on this graph at any point, pressure is P, volume is V, and temperature is T. On this graph at any point, pressure is P, volume is V, temperature is T. Angle made by this straight line graph with X axis or with volume axis is say theta. Okay, then it is a straight line, no doubt. As it is a straight line, we will get y is equal to mx plus c only. Y is equal to mx plus c. Is it a straight line having positive slope or negative slope? Is it the it is a straight line? Is it has positive slope or negative slope? That's negative. That's why you write minus sign directly. Now, along y-axis, as we have taken p, you write p is equal to minus. So slope of this graph means tangent of angle made by the straight line with x-axis or volume axis. So tan theta. Tan theta is called opposite by adjacent. Opposite means AB. By adjacent means BC. AC. Into x. Along x-axis, as we have taken volume V, you write V plus C. So P is equal to minus AB means. What is the length of AB? 3P naught minus P naught. 3P naught minus P naught. Okay, by AC. AC means 2V naught minus V naught. 2V naught minus V naught. Okay, into V plus C. So that is equal to minus, here it is 2P naught, here V naught. So minus 2P naught by V naught. Into V plus C. So this is equation, say one. Now, in this, what is the proportionality constant C we had to find? You see, at a volume V naught, that means at this point, when volume is V naught, pressure is P naught. No? At this point, when volume is V naught, pressure is P naught. You substitute there. On this graph, we have to write, sorry, it is the graph for this. No? It is the graph for BC line. That's why on this graph, BC, you take any point at B. When pressure is P is equal to 3P naught. At that time, volume V is equal to, because it is the equation of, it is a straight line equation for this graph. On this graph only, any point you have to select. You can select B point or C point or any point here. C point, whatever it may be, okay? So, on this line, at this point, when pressure is 3P naught, volume is equal to V naught at this point, at that point. Volume V is equal to V naught. Now, you substitute these considerations here. Pressure is 3P naught. Is equal to minus 2P naught by V naught into volume is V naught. Okay, plus C. V naught cancel. So C is equal to 5P naught now. Therefore, you substitute this value in this equation 1. Therefore, from 1, P is equal to minus half 2P naught by V naught into volume V means volume V only plus C means 5P naught. 5P naught. 5P naught. Okay, that is the pressure volume relation. That is the pressure volume relation. So P is equal to minus 2 P naught by V naught into V plus 5 V naught. Okay, now to obtain the maximum temperature, at what position temperature is maximum? At that maximum temperature position, here only we need the relation between pressure and temperature or volume and temperature. Okay, that's why we have to convert them. It is the equation 2. Any gas, in any process, the gas obeys ideal gas equation PV is equal to nRT. That means PV is equal to RT only, since number of moles is equal to 1 in this case. Okay, from this, P is equal to, we can write RT by V now. P is equal to RT by V. Now, you substitute this P value here. Therefore, 3 into gives, P means RT by V. That is equal to minus half 2 P naught by V naught into V plus 5 P naught. Do cross multiplication. R you write, T is equal to something you write. T is equal to V by R into this total. V by R into this total equation. 2 P naught by V naught into V plus. You don't keep bracket here. Plus 5 P naught. So multiply with V by R. When you multiply with V by R, then we got minus 2 P naught by R V naught into V, V square, plus 5 P naught into V. This is equation 4. Okay, now we got relation between volume and temperature on this BC graph. Suppose if you want to obtain the relation between pressure and temperature, then we have to eliminate the V value. So from this, V is equal to RT by P. Then instead of V, you write RT by P. Then you'll get relation between P and T only. I have taken relation between T and V. We can take any one, no problem. Now, from this equation, where the temperature is maximum, definitely here you see, whenever the volume increases, here volume increases, negative value increases. Whenever the volume increases, you see, whenever volume increases, this negative value increases. Negative value here increases. When negative value increases, then T value gradually decreases. And at certain point, the temperature is maximum. At what point temperature is maximum means, you will see, at a particular volume, temperature becomes zero. You make temperature zero, then V is equal to something you will get. Okay, that means when you move from V to C, the temperature changes and here, somewhere else it becomes zero. Somewhere else it becomes decreases. You see, when volume increases, it also increases now. So we cannot say directly. Here, to obtain the maximum temperature, you differentiate this T with respect to V, because if the temperature is maximum in this case, when temperature is the maximum in this process somewhere else here, then that becomes constant at that particular point. That is the maximum temperature. So when you differentiate this maximum temperature, if you differentiate this temperature with respect to volume or with respect to pressure, that becomes zero only. That's why for T is equal to T max, as it is the relation between T and V, you differentiate this T with respect to volume, D by dV of T, that is equal to zero. And the maximum temperature kavalante, a maximum temperature anedi from V to C graph, at certain point the temperature is maximum. Okay, our maximum temperature is constant for the given system here in this process. Kabatti ee T ni with respect to volume differentiate chesina, pressure differentiate chesina, oka vela ee temperature maximum aithe appudu dan differentiate chesinappudu aa maximum temperature ani fixed kabatti dan differentiate chesthe zero raavali with respect to volume, endukante as we are having the relation between temperature and volume. Now differentiate this one from equation 4. Okay, note up. Okay, from 4, d by dv of t, okay, this is equal to d by dv of t means that value, minus 2 P naught by R V naught into V square plus 5 P naught V. That is equal to 0 for maximum temperature. Okay, therefore, you differentiate this one. Minus 2 P naught by R V naught is constant. D by D of V square means 2 into V. We can write 2 into V power of 2 minus 1. As this function is V, this function is V. D by D of V, even if you write, it becomes 1. Plus D by D V of this one. 5 P naught is constant, you keep outside. D by D V of V means 1. This is equal to 0. Therefore, you bring these two right and you keep here only. Then we will get 4 P naught V by R V naught is equal to 5 P naught you will get. So P naught cancel. That implies V is equal to R V naught by 4. No. So exactly at the volume R V naught by 4. At the volume R V naught by 4, the temperature is maximum. At the volume R V naught by 4. R is also cancelling. Is R is there or not? Here, by R is there, no? By R. R is there. Here also R is there. Okay, R will be cancelled. So R will be cancelled. Then I got only V naught by 4. I got only V naught by 4. Okay. So at this particular volume V naught by 4, fourth equation unit. Okay. You see here, just I brought this V R by V to right. I did cross multiplication with V by R here. V I brought to right. R also I brought to right. Then it becomes V by R, no? T is equal to V by R into this total part. I have written. Okay, then minus V by R, when you multiply with this, minus 2 P naught by R V naught into V V square plus 5 P naught into V by R, 5 P naught V by R. Okay. Okay, now, right. Now, so exactly at a volume V is equal to V naught by 4, definitely the temperature is maximum. So what is that maximum temperature? Okay, now from equation 4, therefore at V is equal to V naught by 4, T is equal to T max. So when by treating this temperature as maximum, when you differentiated with V, I got V is equal to V naught by 4. That means at a volume V naught by 4, the temperature is maximum. So at volume V is equal to V naught by 4, the temperature is maximum. So now we have to substitute that value. Is it correct value or not? Is it correct or not? V is equal to P naught cancel, of course. 4 P naught. Okay, 5 by 4, no? 5 V naught by 4. 5 V naught by 4, yes. 5 V naught by 4. Okay. Okay, Dheeraj ready. Is it correct? Okay, Dheeraj ready. Now it's okay. Okay, now. So this is the volume. Okay, 5 V naught by 4. At this volume, the temperature is maximum. Now at this volume, you find the temperature. Then that is the maximum temperature from equation 4. From 4. At volume V is equal to this one, the temperature is maximum. So you substitute this V is equal to 5 V naught by 4 in the equation 4. So therefore, T max is equal to, when you substitute this volume, this one, in this formula, then temperature is maximum. That's why T max is equal to minus 2 P naught by R V naught into V square means 5 V naught by 4 4 square plus 5 P naught by R into V means 5 V naught by 4. Now you simplify that. Minus 2 P naught by R V naught into 25 V naught square by 16 plus 25 V naught by 4R. Okay. V naught here square cancel. Then minus 50 V naught by 16R plus 25 V naught by 4R. When you take LCM, 16R is LCM, then it becomes minus 50 V naught plus 4R, 4R, that means 4 into 25, 100, 100 V naught. Therefore, 50 V naught by 16R, that is equal to 25 V naught by 8R, no? 225 is that, 28 is that. So 25 P0 P0 by 8R. Therefore, maximum temperature T max is equal to 25 P0 V0 by 8R. That is the answer. It is the maximum temperature. Okay. In this way, we had to do. Yeah. 25 P0 V0 by 8R. That is the answer. No doubt. Board is blurred. Remaining people, please respond. Is board is clear or not? Remaining people, please respond. Is board clear or not? Clear only. Keshav Gupta. I think you adjust the system. Keshav Gupta. Okay, okay, now thank you. Now okay, Keshav Gupta. Okay. Right now. Have you noted? Have you noted this one? One more example. It is one example, one set today. Always it is in your notes, you see them. Okay, next example two. Figure here, we are given internal energy versus pressure graph. In the figure, here we are given internal energy versus pressure graph. Internal energy capital U versus pressure. Internal energy pressure graph is given. The figure shows the variation of internal energy with the pressure. So U is the internal energy of the gas. Tell me, what is the internal energy of the gas at any temperature capital T? What is the internal energy of the graph? Internal energy of the gas at any temperature capital T? F by 2 nRT we can write, or in terms of gamma, how we can write? NCV, yeah, very good. Very good, Nana. Sandesh. NCV T, N into R by gamma minus 1 into T we can write. R in other words, F by 2 NRT also we can write for internal energy. Okay. F by 2 NRT is there, no? F by 2 NRT. F by 2 small n RT. Small n is the number of moles. R F by 2 NKT, where N, capital N. Capital N means number of molecules. Okay, we can write. Right. Internal energy, U is the internal energy. Of course, P is the pressure. P, pressure. So here, figure shows the variation of internal energy with the pressure of the 2 moles of the gas in cyclic process. Number of moles of the gas is equal to 2 moles. Given. Here the graph is given like this. The state changes takes place from A to B, B to C, C to D, and D to A. Okay. The temperature of gas at C and D. At C and D, the temperatures are TC is equal to. At C, temperature is 300 Kelvin. At D, temperature is TD. That is equal to 500 Kelvin. Temperatures are given. Heat absorbed in the process is 400 R. Heat absorbed in the process is 400 R ln x. Heat absorbed. Heat absorbed Q is equal to 400 R ln x. So what is the x value they ask? What is the x value they ask? Okay. So here, it is the heat energy absorbed in the entire process. Heat energy absorbed in the entire cyclic process, not only along one path. Along one path or along from A to B, B to C, along A to B, heat energy lost. Or of course heat energy changes. Internal energy changes. That's why heat energy changes from B to C. Internal energy is it changes or not? No change. Because you see here from A to B, internal energy decreases. From A to B, internal energy decreases. Because you see at this point A internal energy is maximum, at point B internal energy is minimum. Okay, that's why the internal energy decreases from A to B. Whenever internal energy decreases, temperature falls. Okay, along BC path, BC path is parallel to pressure axis or perpendicular to internal energy axis, means at any point on this graph, internal energy remains constant. Whenever internal energy remains constant, temperature is also constant, no? That's why temperature at point B is same as temperature at C, as temperature is constant along this path. Similarly, here also, temperature at A is equal to temperature at D, because this, on this line, at any point, the internal energy remains constant. That's why temperature remains constant. Here, at constant temperature, as from B to C, whatever the temperature remains constant. That's why internal energy remains constant. But from B to C, whenever temperature remains constant, as the pressure increases, volume decreases, no? You see, from B to C, as the temperature remains constant, at constant temperature, pressure is directly proportional to volume. Pressure and volume remains constant according to Boyle's law. At constant temperature, PV is called constant. When P increases, volume decreases. Volume decreases means gas is compressed here. When gas is compressed, heat energy is rejected. Gas compressed in a pro, heat energy reject out, and the loss of. Okay. And the heat energy rejected means heat is lost by the system to the surroundings. And the heat loss of. Next, from C to D process. Okay. Temperature increases. Internal energy increases out on the. Intensity increase out on the temperature increase out on the. It is also clear from this data also. Temperature increases. Pressure constant only. And a constant pressure, pressure increase out on the volume increase out on the and a gas expand out on. Gas expand out on the external work plan is positive. Ikademo, gas compressed out on the external work plan is negative. Here, external work plan is positive. Okay. In this way, we have to check. So, first of all, from A to B, we will consider. From A to B, what is the heat energy absorbed or whatever the work done we had find? From A to B, internal energy decreases. From A to B, internal energy decreases. Okay. So in this case, what is the work done in this process? From A to B, as the temperatures are known, change in internal energy is known. From this process, change in internal energy is known. Work done In this process, work done also calculated. Work done can be calculated. That's why the heat energy absorbed or rejected in this process we can calculate. Okay, from A to B, is the pressure is constant or variable? Tell me. From A to B, is the pressure is constant or variable? From A to B, is the pressure constant or variable? Tell me. Pressure is constant. So at constant pressure, the process here, the state changes takes place from A to B at constant pressure. That means isobaric process. In isobaric process, what is the amount of heat energy absorbed? In this isobaric process, what is the amount of heat energy absorbed? Okay, first of all, we have to calculate the work done in this isobaric process. From A to B, what is the work done in this isobaric process? At constant pressure on this graph, what is the work done? So work done WAB is equal to, we can write integral PdV, we can write, but information regarding pressure, volume are not given. That's why this integral PdV can also be written as integral NRDT, you know, since PdV is equal to NRDT. PdV is equal to NRDT, we can write. Okay. So PdV is equal to NR into DT. PdV is equal to NRDT. That's integral NRDT. That's equal to NR is constant you write outside into integral DT. Integral DT means here whenever the state changes takes place from A to B, final temperature is this one, initial temperature is this one, TB minus TA. Number of moles is given to 2R into temperature at B, that is equal to same as at C, that's why 300 Kelvin minus 500, TA means 500, that is equal to minus 400 R. It is the work done in the process from A to B. In this way, you have to calculate the work done. Okay, minus 400 R is the work done. Next, because total work done in entire process you calculate. As the cyclic process it is, in cyclic process change in trends is zero now. Total change in entrance is equal to zero now in the cyclic process, because after passing through different states here, again the system come back to the initial state A only. A again the state change start B to C, C to D, again it come back to A. In cyclic process, as the system come back to the initial state only, after passing through different states here, as it come back to the initial state only, temperature remains constant. When temperature remains constant in the cyclic process, then there is no change in the internal energy in the cyclic process. In the cyclic process, a part of the cyclic process, when you consider, there is a change in internal energy. When you consider entire cyclic process, the change in internal energy is zero. In cyclic process, finally, as the system comes back to the initial state only, the state changes starts from A, and after passing through different states, it comes back to the state A only. That's why no change in the temperature. That's why no change in the internal energy. In the entire cyclic process. So in the entire cyclic process, there is no change in the internal energy. That's why change in internal energy is zero. So from first law of thermodynamics, dq is equal to du plus dw. dq is equal to du zero plus dw. That means in this entire cyclic process, they ask what is the heat energy absorbed? They ask it. In this entire process, what is the heat energy? They ask it. They did not ask what is the heat energy absorbed from A to B or B to C like that. In the entire process, what is the heat energy? They asked it. In the entire process, the change in trends is zero. That's why the amount of heat energy absorbed or rejected is equal to work done only, equal to external work done only. That's why I am calculating work done in different process. In the entire cyclic process, what is the total work done means? We have to add the work done from A to B, B to C, C to D, D to A. We have to calculate work done. Why we have to calculate the work done in each and every process means it is not the PV graph. If it is PV graph, definitely the area bounded by closed curve is equal to work done only. But it is not the PV graph. It is the UP graph. It's very, very important. Okay? So if U internal energy versus P graph is given, we have to do the problem like this. Okay? Work done in the process from A to B is this one. Next. Work done in the process from B to C. WBC. You see, in B to C process, what is the type of process from B to C? Tell me. What is the type of process from B to C? It is the internal energy. Here, this is internal energy. Internal energy. From B to C process. Yeah, very good. Isothermal process. Pramitesh. B to C process, internal energy constant only. And temperature constant. ఇక్కడ టెంపరేచర్ కాన్స్టెంట్ ఇది, ఎందుకంటే ఇంటర్నల్ కాన్స్టెంట్ ఉంది కదా, ఇంటర్నల్ బి టు సి కాన్స్టెంట్ గా ఉన్నట్టుగా ఎక్కడ వేరీ అవట్లా. ఇది ఇట్ ఈస్ అ స్ట్రైట్ లైన్ పర్పెండిక్యులర్ టు ఇంటర్నల్ యాక్సిస్, మీన్స్ ఎట్ ఎనీ పాయింట్ ఇంటర్నల్ రిమైన్స్ సేమ్ వాట్ ఎవర్ ద వాల్యూ హియర్ దట్ ఇస్ ఓన్లీ. దట్స్ ఇట్ ఇస్ ద హియర్ టెంపరేచర్ ఇస్ కాన్స్టెంట్, దట్ మీన్స్ ఐథర్నల్ ప్రాసెస్ హియర్ ఆల్సో ఇంటర్నల్ డస్ నాట్ చేంజ్, దట్స్ వై హియర్ ఆల్సో టెంపరేచర్ ఇస్ కాన్స్టెంట్. దిస్ టూ ప్రాసెస్ ఆర్ ఐథర్నల్ ప్రాసెస్. When temperature is constant, the gases obey the isothermal process. That means it obeys the Boyle's law equation. That's why in this case, Boyle's law we had applied. Boyle's law means isothermal process. In isothermal process, what is the formula for work done? Already we derived. In isothermal process, what is the formula for work done means nRT log V2 by V1. Of course, ln. nRT ln V2 by V1. Or 2.303 nRT log V2 by V1 we can write. But answer is given in natural logarithms only. That's why in logs only. That's why you write in log only. So nRT log V2 by V1. But V2 V1 information is not there. Here pressures are given. Here pressures are given. Okay, well, here you see. From V to C, as the temperature is constant, pressure volume changes. Okay, how we can find the relation between V2 and V1? Here temperature is given. Here temperature we know. Here temperature we know. Okay. So relation between pressure and volume can be to be calculated. How we can calculate volumes? If you know the volumes, we can have the work done in the process from B to C. How we can calculate? Here pressures are given in the problem. Pressures are given in the diagram. Here pressure is P naught. Here pressure is 2P naught given. In the problem only pressures are given. But we know the relation between V, volumes and work done. Okay, that's why here in isothermal process P1 V1 is equal to P2 V2. No? So therefore work done in the BC process is equal to nR into in BC process temperature is. In BC process, temperature is constant. That's why you write TC or TV. TC or TV. TC, right? Into ln. V2 by V1. V2 by V1 means, of course, here, pressure at this point is PA. Volume is V1. Pressure is PB. Volume is VB. So, pressure at B. Because state changes takes place from V to C. That's why pressure at B and volume at B is equal to pressure at C, volume at C. So here this is equal to nRT, nRT means TC into V2 minus V1. Final volume minus initial volume means VC by VB we had right, VC by VB. But we are not given the information regarding volumes. That volumes must be written in terms of pressures. VB, VC by VB, VC by VB means PB by PC, no? VC by VB means PB by PC. Now we substitute the data. So N means 2. Number of moles 2 is given, R into temperature at C. Temperature at C, R, B, that is equal to 300 Kelvin. So you write 300 because temperature must be in Kelvin equivalent, not in degrees centigrade. Because in all these gas equations, the temperature is in Kelvin scale only. So ln, PB, pressure at B is P naught by PC, pressure at C is 2 P naught. That is equal to 600 R into ln 1 by 2. Ln 1 by 2 means minus ln 2 we can write now because ln 1 by 2 means ln 1 minus ln 2. Ln 1 0 minus ln into minus ln 2. So into minus ln 2 you write. Of course ln 1 by 2 means minus ln 2 you will get. Therefore that is equal to minus 600 Kepler into ln 2. This is another value of 4. Another work done in the process from B to C. Similarly from C to D, what is the work done? D to A, what is the work done? We have to calculate. Okay? You know the? This method is also very, very important. For each and every point, it is important for mains also. From B to C, in this case, what is the work done? How we calculate the work done? How we can find the change in transit? Of course, from B to C, change in transit is zero. From C to D, how we can calculate the change in transit? how we can calculate the work done in this process. Everyone is important. Every point may be asked in mains as a problem. Okay. Yeah, ln 1 is 0. That's why we got ln 1 by 2. We got here 600 R into ln 1 by 2. That equals 600 R into ln 1 minus ln 2. Since ln 1 is equal to 0, I got minus ln 2. So minus 600 R ln 2 I have written. Okay. Okay, Madhur Mehta. Minus 600 R ln 2. Of course, number of moles is given to, and work in the process from A to B. A to B is equal to, we got minus 400 R. Worked in the process from B to C, we got minus 600 R ln 2. Okay, next. Shall I write this part? Yeah, you want to write something. Shall I write this part? Now, from C to D process. In C to D process, no doubt internalizing changes because at C internalizing here, at D internalizing here. As the temperatures are given, change internalizing from C to D process we can calculate. And at constant pressure, you see, at point C and D pressure is constant, but temperature increase. At constant pressure, volume is directly proportional to temperature. No? As the temperature increases, volume also increases. That's why here work is done and change and increase in transit is also there. Okay, therefore, in the process from C to D, what is the external work done? We have to calculate. What is the external work done? We have to calculate. Because there is no need of calculating the change in transit. Because in the process from, in this cyclic process, entire cyclic process, change in transit is zero only. Here they asked, what is the net amount of heat energy rejected or supplied? They asked. Net amount of heat energy, they asked. That's why you need not calculate the change in internal energy from C to D process or D to A process like that. Of course, if you want to find, if they ask, means if they ask what is the change in internal energy from C to D process means as the temperatures are known here, then we can write NCV into TD minus TC. Because in order to find the change in internal energy, we are having formula NCV DT, no? DT means final temperature minus initial temperature. So NCV into TD minus TC, sorry, NCP into TD minus TC, because pressure is constant here. As the pressure is constant here, sorry, change in internal energy, you know, we have calculated change in internal energy in C to D process. That's why NCV into DT only. N into CV means R by gamma minus 1 into TD minus TC. That is the change in internal energy in this process. But here, we need not calculate the change in internal energy because in the entire cyclic process, as it is a cyclic process, change in internal energy is zero. That's why even you calculate the change in internal energy in this process, in this process, in this process, in this process, you add them, you will get zero only. Change in internal energy is zero only. We need not calculate. Only if you calculate work done in all processes, then that gives the total heat energy supplied or rejected. Okay, total work done in the process from C to D. As it is the isobaric process, pressure is constant, no? Here pressure is constant. That's why at constant pressure, what is the work done in this case? At constant pressure, how we can calculate work done? PdV is equal to, at constant pressure, PdV is equal to nRdT, no? That's why work done in the process from C to D is equal to nRdT, we can write. nR into dT means Pd minus Tc. Integral PdV is equal to nRdT. That is equal to nR into Tb minus Tc, no? That is the formula for work done in the process from C to D. That is equal to n means 2 r into td minus tc. Td means 500 minus tc means 300. Therefore, that is equal to 400 r is the work done in the process from C to D. That is over. Next, from B to A. From D to A process, what is the work done? D to A process, what is the work done? In D to A process, temperature is constant, no? Because from D to A, as the entropy remains constant, temperature is constant. That's why here it is the isobaric process. From C to D, it is the isobaric. That's why I use this formula. Our integral PD also we can use. D to A process, as U is constant, U is equal to U is U T are constant. That's why isothermal process takes place. Isothermal process. In isothermal process, what is the formula for work done? Work done from B to C is equal to nRT. T means we can, okay, first you write general formula, nRT into ln V2 by V1 or T1 by P2 we can write. Already previously I have written, this is equal to nRT means temperature, constant temperature on this graph is equal to, we can write TA or TD, TD you write, TD into ln P1 by P2. Initial here at this point, the initial pressure is here because D to A graph means the pressure here is initial, pressure here is final. That's why P1 by P2 means actually V2 by V1 formula. V2 by V1 is equal to, we can write P1 by P2 also. So initial pressure at D, that means that is PD by PA. It is the general formula. Now it's substitute. N means 2R into temperature at D is 500 Kelvin. So into 500 into ln. PD means 2P0 by PA. PA means pressure P0. That is equal to 1000 R ln 2. It is the work done in the process. Therefore, net work done in the entire process. Net work done. Net work done in the entire process. DW or simple DW. That is equal to WAB plus WBC. Plus W C A C D plus W D A. Therefore, net work in the process W is equal to, you say it is W is equal to W A B minus 400 R plus W B C minus 600 R ln 2 plus W B C. W B C I have written W C D plus 400 R plus W D A. WDA, no, it is WDA is equal to plus 1000 R ln 2. That's equal to minus 400 R plus 400 R cancel. Okay, minus 600 R ln 2, 1000 R ln 2. That means 400 plus 400 R ln 2. It is the network done. So in this cyclic process from DQ is equal to, from DQ is equal to DU plus DW or Q is equal to delta U plus delta W. In this entire process, cyclic process, change in entropy is zero. That's why heat energy supplied is equal to work done, net work done. That is equal to net work done is equal to this only. Positive value we got 400 R ln 2. So this is the answer. 400 R ln 2. We got positive sign means heat energy absorbed by the system. Here they asked, what is the heat energy absorbed? Yeah, heat energy absorbed is positive only, you know. If you get negative, heat energy last we will get. So heat energy absorbed. Here answer is given like this. 400 R ln X given. Okay, therefore X is equal to 2. 2 is the answer. Very good. Okay, this is the answer. In this way we have to do. Right now. Okay, with this I will stop the class. Next class we will see. Next class, one cylinder with spring is there. Piston is fixed with spring, that one, and Carnot's heat engine is there. I will explain that concept. Okay, bye all of you. Today you revise the thermometry and expansion of solids. Okay, bye all of you. No, there is no extra class today. Only in study hour we will meet. No extra class. Okay, bye all of you. In this week we are having only revision. Mainly we are having revision only. Okay, right. Bye all of you. Be possible. I will, in thermometry and expansion of solids, I will send the assignment. Otherwise, you revise the completed topics. Okay. Thermometry and expansion of solids. Bye, Nana. Bye, Alapi.